September 5, 2004, The Dignity of Women in Society and Church. Collaboration of men and women in the church and in the world was the theme of a letter to the bishops from the Vatican Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith. The following are paraphrases and reflections on that letter. The letter reflected particularly on the dignity of women and their place in civil society and in the church. It addressed certain ideas today that create blocks to the authentic advancement of women. Noting abuses by men in exerting power over women, some demand an opposition between men and women. Some prefer to deny the differences between the sexes. This opens the door to allowing for more than one model of family as the building block of society. By denying a difference between the sexes, we deny that humanity's having two genders participates in the image of God. The Bible's account of creation of woman as the helpmate of man certainly does not imply inferiority. Elsewhere, God is described as helpmate. Man and woman are created to be one, equals and complementary. It is sin that disrupts this relationship. Instead of directing oneself to the other is seen as a prize to be conquered. With Jesus' victory over sin, the relationship of man and woman is given the possibility to be recovered. Sacrificial love is understood as the appropriate spousal relationship. Among the fundamental values linked to women's actual lives is what has been called a capacity for the other. This intuition is linked to women's physical capacity to give life. Whether lived out or remaining potential, this capacity is a reality that structures the female personality in a profound way. Women tend to develop a sense of seriousness of life and of its responsibilities, a respect for what is concrete. It is women, in the end, who even in very desperate situations, as attested by history, past and present, possess a singular capacity to persevere in adversity, to keep life going even in extreme situations, to hold tenaciously to the future, and finally to remember with tears the value of every human life. Virginity refutes any attempt to enclose women in mere biological destiny. Motherhood and virginity complement each other, expressing that every Christian way of life is one of a concrete gift of oneself to the other. The role of woman implies, first of all, being actively present in the family. It is here above all that the features of a people take shape. It also means that women should be present in the world of work and the organization of society. It must be noted that feminine values are above all human values. It is only because women are more immediately attuned to them that they are the reminded and privileged sign of these values.